2018 and 10 Minute History is asking for some questions, and you answered. I've been meaning to do a Q&A for a while now, and I figured that I'd make this a yearly thing, but just so you know, there's not going to be anything on the screen. There's no announcements, nothing like that, just to let you know. So we'll start with some of the most common questions. Why did you start making videos? So the reason I started making videos was that I wanted to be a teacher, and so in order to supplement my application, I figured I would make these videos to show people that I was dedicated and I had something else to bring. Long story short, I'm not a teacher. The reason being was that when I asked people who were teachers or who were training to be teachers, they told me the same thing. Don't ever be a teacher. What's the process of making videos? How do you study for each video? Do you only use books as a source, or do you use online materials as well? So when I start making an episode, the first thing I do after the topic is picked is that I look at the exam boards and their specifications to see what the exams are going to ask for, so I can include that. In terms of how I study, it's normally just getting books from the library or normally buying them now and then just going through them. I start with some overview books and then I'll normally get some more nuanced academic texts. As for only using books as a source, yeah, that's normally what I do. The reason being is that I have access to things, say, like JSTOR, but I know that other people don't, and so me citing things like that isn't particularly helpful, especially when you consider the fact that these are aimed at A-level students. How do you always make the videos 10 minutes? This has been something that I've consciously done since the very beginning. I mean, the first one is it's a challenge, and so I quite like the idea of breaking something down and sort of condensing it to 10 minutes. As for why it was 10 minutes, it was originally going to be 12 minutes history, but then I wanted to do 20% less work every time, and so I did. How did you decide on your current format and style? Well, it was pretty much the first episode. It was, it was the French Revolution and Napoleon. I decided that I wanted people to die at the beginning, and I was going to start by... So for example, the reason why I say the date, date and X is because I didn't know how to begin the first episode, and so I figured I would just do that for all of them. Do you have a job aside from this, or do you still study? No, I don't have any other job except for this one. YouTube is fortunately my full-time job, so that's a weird thing to say. As for whether or not I still study, I don't this year, although in September I'll be starting a master's. Did you go to college, university, and if you did, what did you study? So in June of this year, I graduated with a BA in history, and it was a 2-1. Vague age in university? 28, and I went to Cambridge. Is there any part of history you'd personally enjoy to make that you haven't yet? Yeah, there's quite a few things I'd really like to do for the channels, but it's a combination of things. So take the Renaissance. I'd love to do that, but people aren't really interested in it. Another one is that I've been sitting on a script for The Birth of Islam for about 14 months now, and I'm far too scared to actually do anything with it. How many people are involved in making this channel? Only one, just me. Will you finish your English-British history series? The short answer is no. The long answer is that the series didn't really perform very well, and that's not necessarily the fault of English-British history itself, although the World History series has the advantage of merely talking about other countries' highlights, whereas British history has to talk about all of it. The channel wasn't large enough to have that sort of a switching content, and so it didn't really make sense for the time. I was in my third year of university, which is, it's not a good thing to mix. What are your plans for 2019? So the plans for 2019 is that my New Year's resolution is to actually pull my finger out and do a much better job now. The plan is for 2019 is to continue with world history. The idea is that I'm going to release one every 2 weeks, probably on a Saturday, and then say 2 or 3 days beforehand it's going to go out to the patrons to give them a bit more of an incentive and also a thank you for actually supporting me. Another question from literally everyone, will you cover X? Probably, at some point. I tend to prefer things that are on the British curriculum, but say things like Vichy France I'm more than happy to do, things that are just interesting, but I'm happy to cover anything, but the problem is that a lot of things in history are quite controversial, and so I largely just can't be bothered to deal with it. Favourite video you've made to date? Probably the dissolution of the USSR. It was nice to do something a bit more modern, something that I was actually alive when it happened. Not the 50s bit, obviously, but the 90s bit. I always enjoyed the fact that I could draw things like astronauts and tanks and rockets, and it was just a bit more interesting than, you know, horsey boys. What was the hardest video to research? None of them have been massively difficult, mainly because what I do, so it's... Because it's simply overview content, saying that The Birth of Islam was actually quite difficult because the first sort of quarter of it's devoted to the Sasanian and Byzantine empires, which the Byzantine Empire, there's a lot of stuff on it, but the Sasanian Empire is, it's a bit more difficult to get hold of good books that other people can get hold of. Barring that, actually one surprise was the American Revolution that I've written the script for, because there's really very few good overview texts available in the UK. How badly have you been affected by the apocalypse? Genuinely, I don't know because I didn't monetize my channel until March. And so this was after all of that happened. So I only know my post-adpocalypse life. And so hopefully it gets better, but I don't know if it's gotten that much worse. So I can't really tell you. What made you choose the art style you use? I can't draw. Which empire in history is your favorite? Probably the Portuguese, mainly because I like the fact that it's a bit different. You know, the French Empire, the British Empire, the Spanish Empire, the Russian Empire. It's just people turning up and taking stuff. And whilst the Portuguese did that, they did it in a way that was slightly different, where they recognized their own limitations, except for sort of the whole we're going to split the world in half with the Spanish bit. That wasn't where you recognized it. But barring that, yeah, it's probably the most interesting empire, as far as I'm concerned anyway. Would you ever put out a compilation of moments where you've messed up your narration? Yes, and there's hours of it. So I'm more than happy to at some point, maybe April the 1st or maybe this time next year. I have no idea. Ever going to cover alt history like Kaiserreich? The original plan actually was to do an alt history episode every April the 1st. The problem is that it kind of detracts from what I'm doing, and also I'm really bad at keeping any sort of promises. So if I wanted to do a Kaiserreich one, it would just push back other episodes, and I'm just not good enough to really do that at the moment. Perhaps in the future, but no. What history topic do you find the most boring? So this is going to be a controversial answer, but it's probably military history. I don't really find the questions posed to be very useful. I mean, that depends if that's what you think history is supposed to be about. Defenders of military history often talk about how it's supposed to be about the soldiers, about how it's supposed to be about what they went through, about how awful war was. But I often find that when you do look at military history, especially on YouTube, it tends to be nothing more than look how good this tank is, look how bad this tank is, look how amazing this general was. And it doesn't answer very much. And so the most controversial thing I'm going to say about military history is I think its academic reputation is probably deserved. Do you have a history book you would highly recommend? Yeah, there's one by Mary E. Wisner-Hanks. I think it's called Early Modern Europe, 1450 to 1798, or something to that effect. It's a fantastic book. If you want to know anything about early modern Europe, then you should absolutely get that one. If you could have dinner with one historical figure, who would it be and why? If you could have dinner with one historical figure, who would it be and why? Well, they'd have to be English speaking, and they'd have to be sort of from after the 19th century, so they wouldn't stink, but I don't know, probably a politician. I mean, that sounds awful because I feel the idea of if you want to speak to current politicians in 20 years, it would be pretty awful. But I don't know, maybe I'd speak to King Edward VIII or something. He'd be quite interesting. How important is debunking historical misconceptions to you? Generally, it isn't. I'm not in the sort of debunking business. I think that there's a lot of channels that try to go down that road, the sort of gotcha, you're wrong, look how amazing I am kind of deal. But when it comes to history, because I do such broad content, I can never be an expert in said content. So if I went down the road of here's why X and Y is wrong, I would just do it a disservice. And then you sort of strengthen the other side's argument. And also, I also feel that history is one of those things where people are getting very personally involved now. And I'm not sure if that's really the best road to go down. If you had a time machine, where would you go and when would you go? I wouldn't, because there's no modern medicine, and also I'd miss the internet. Who is your favorite YouTuber? There's been loads that I've watched over the years, and sort of my favorites tend to move in and out of favor, as it were. Probably the first channel I ever subscribed to was OMFG Catter, or Jesse Cox, and so he was the one who made me think, oh, these people actually do it full time, isn't that really interesting? In terms of favourite, I mean, you can't go wrong with anything that's got Indy Neidell in it, or Exerbia, he's a really good channel. I'm also a big fan of Feature History and Sweeney and The Great War and World War II in Real Time and Crash Course and all of these sort of things. There's loads. Outside of history, I watch Hat Films, I watch Dead Meat, I watch Kirioff TV, he's a Warhammer channel, he's fantastic, seriously. If you're interested in any of that, subscribe to him. What part of England are you from? So I was born and raised in a place called Peterborough, and it's a really, really interesting place. And so if you are ever in Peterborough, the first thing I'd recommend you do is leave. What are your hobbies? Outside of history, I'm a massive politics buff. I really enjoy sort of reading literature. I mean, science fiction is something that I've gotten back into recently, but also outside of that, I love cooking. I'm a massive, massive fan of basically cooking any sort of Italian food or Mexican food. I'm terrible at it, but I do enjoy it. What are your political views? So I try to keep all of those out of the videos. I'm not going to sort of mention it because I feel like it undermines everything. But shameless fence sitting aside, I feel that YouTubers who claim to be educational but also sort of place their own political beliefs into it are really undermining what they're supposed to be doing. It's not for us to convince people of a certain viewpoint. It's for us to say, this is what happened. Make up your own damn mind. Anyway, that's this video done. Got to keep it the correct length. And a special thanks, as always, to my patrons who are James Bizanet, Thomas Gestrich, Adam Harvey, and Winston Kaywood. There's really nothing else to say at the end of this. I don't have any book recommendations or anything, so just hope you have a great day.